It's Syreena from the Falco family, where homeschool is life and having a teachable spirit is our number one goal. The kids are outside. It has been blizzard weather for like ever around here, and we got one day of really decent weather. So Brian is out washing the car with the kids, which gives me a moment inside the house with some silence to go ahead and try and film something. So I'm gonna do a little plan with me. I pretty much already planned my first week of this month with my patron fam, but I'm gonna go in and just keep moving along on my plans with this second and third week. We are doing a math boot camp. What I basically do, you guys, is I think about the last couple of months. In this case, it was like the last few months of 2018. And I really think about the challenges that I had as far as my mind was concerned. The things that I felt like I was tempted to be insecure the most about in homeschool. And I definitely knew exactly what that was this time around, which was math. More importantly, it was math for my oldest. Instead of meditating on those negative things and those insecurities, I am learning to just pinpoint those things and attack them head on. So since I was having a few insecurities about whether or not I was progressing nicely with math, with my oldest in particular, I went ahead and decided to do a math boot camp. I've done math boot camp before, but the last two times it lasted for like 1 or 2 weeks. This time around, I'm planning on it lasting for a couple of months. I think this just gives me more than enough time to just kind of focus in on the things that I feel like could use a little bit of reinforcement. I do have a lot of fun ideas, but I always want to pace myself and start slowly. I definitely want to make sure that I let the kids know that there's really no substitution for just good hard work, especially as far as math is concerned. So I don't want to like start off from the gate with a whole bunch of fun, exciting things to do. So this first week, we just kind of started working on just having some extra pockets of time that we are getting in practice in different areas of math. And that's how we started out. And the way that I make things fun during this time is to use like a lot of our pretend play type of things, so that it's not really making it too much of a big deal, but it's still making it, you know, a little bit fun. They were getting in some nice, good, hard work the first day of our math boot camp, and I came back into the room with this. They all laughed. There's definitely no shortage of giggles from the kids. So that's what I mean by making sure that I get like the basics covered for that first week, but not making it too much of a fun and exciting thing, if that makes any sense. Now that we've moved through the first week, I want to start implementing some more fun things and just being, I mean, just pointing out through our everyday studies all the math that is around us. So we've done an excellent job doing that. I thought I'd just lay out some of the things that we've been using along the way and show you guys kind of a little bit more into how I am going about planning this math boot camp. I'm hoping to get around to cleaning off their chalk walls and things. Not this one. This one's not going anywhere just yet, but cleaning off the chalk wall in their room, the two chalk clouds that I have over here. So I want to get something on there that's math related. Then I'm probably also gonna plan to have something here each morning. Right now that is my plan. So let me just start by showing you some of the things that I laid out. I feel like I've done a decent job bringing things into our homeschool that are easy for me to just kind of move around and use for different purposes. So there's really not gonna be any new things that I am planning to add, meaning I'm not making any new purchases. I'm just shopping my homeschool room and using what I have. First thing that I did was just pull out everything that was math related, you guys. Anything math related. So this little math set with the protractor and the ruler and all those things, inside is something that I pulled out because we haven't quite used this yet. I grabbed cookbooks because we're going to be doing a lot of measurement practice and things like that. So these they received for Christmas. So I have this Kid Chef Everyday book, Kid Chef Bakes, and Kid Chef Junior. So we're gonna be cooking our way and baking our way through these books with a little help from our friends. These cute little measuring cups that came in their little cooking kits for Christmas. I got pink ones for Savannah and blue ones for the boys. And then I also got a baking rolling mat for Savannah in this cute pink color. And I think this is gonna be really helpful for us doing measurements in real life. This should be a lot of fun. I pulled out the math books that I had just because Savannah's had quite a bit of moments lately where she runs up to me and says, what do I do now? So things like this always come in handy because they just give me something a little bit extra and a little bit different that I could switch it up from time to time when she hits me with one of those statements. These big die that I got from Five Below, these always come in handy. We use these just to do a few basic, really simple math games. Together, I pulled out the Osmo. So the Osmo is one of those things that we don't do on a daily basis, and this is the perfect time for this. So I'm just using the Osmo numbers and Osmo Tangram and the Osmo Pizza Company. It's nice to hide these type of things away for a little bit so that when you do pull it out again, they feel like it's fun and exciting all over again because we haven't used it in some time. I got a few books to get us started. Three of these circumference books. They're math adventure books. I know that there's a lot more of these, but I just started with these three. Circumference and the First Round Table. Circumference and the Sword in the Cone. Circumference and the Great Knight of Angoland. So I got the three of those. Of course, I grabbed my little math manipulatives that I use quite often. So I have these animals here. And then I also have bugs, and I also have dragons. I have my Moby numbers. It took me a while to get it because it is $20. I picked this one up from Amazon. The really simple way to try different math games. Maybe I can show you some of the games that we use. They're super simple, which is why I never really, you know, think to do videos on them, but just the way we do math games, because there's lots of games that I have in my Amazon wish list that I would love to be able to get, but the reality is that I want to try to keep things as simple as possible, especially because of our goals of being more of a traveling and on-the-go homeschool family. I just don't want to get into the habit of bringing too much into the homeschool and getting too used to that. I just want us to use our creativity to find new ways to use basic homeschool resources and supplies. So we'll see how that goes. It takes a lot of discipline not to pick up all of those games that I really would like to have, but I know that ultimately our goal is to be more on the go and more of a traveling family, so I need to make decisions that that lead in that direction. Those are my Moby tiles. I also picked these up from the library, which I was really excited about. I got three of these bedtime math books. I thought these were so cute. So inside of them, they have little chapters. This one is on wild pets, and they will go through a little story here. And then they'll have a math problem for wee ones, for little kids, and for big kids. And you just do one of these every night. This one says, for wee ones, if your pet chameleon has two spiny eyeballs, two horns, and a really long tongue, how many unusual body parts is that? And then the big kids, if your chameleon can show off 9 different colors, how many more colors does it need to show off to keep up with your 24 color box of crayons? So this was a really exciting find for me, and I got three of them. This one is Bedtime Math The Truth Comes Out, and this one is Bedtime Math Squared. This time it's personal. Then along with that, of course, I try to find books that are very much so math related. So here is an example. This one is Hidden Figures we just finished reading. The True Story of 4 Black Women and the Space Race. We have studied the space race raised at several times during our homeschool journey. So this is nice because it hits on that topic again, something that they're very familiar with. And we just went through this one. And while this covers history, it most certainly covers math. And it really helps them to understand. My point that I was trying to get across and what really helped them to understand that we use math for a purpose. It's not just to be able to sit down and complete the math problems, but they will actually help you to be able to do other things in life. And in this case, these women were mathematicians, which helped them to accomplish their goals and problem solve in outer space and flight. So this was really nice to be able to go through this one with them so that they would get a nice grasp of why it's important to use math and why it's important to have those skills. This one I pulled out of my homeschool library. This was a discarded book in my library a while ago, The Secret Life of Money, A Kid's Guide to Cash. So this is something I'm going to pull from. Of course, I grabbed this one, The Everything You Need to Ace Math in One Big Fat Notebook. I'm really proud of myself because this is one of those things, those resources you pick up and you know that it's a good resource, but trying to figure out where it fits in and how you can use it in different ways is the challenge, really. This is like a middle school age book and my kids are definitely elementary age. So a lot of the content inside of here is a bit above what you would think I'd be able to use. But surprisingly, I've been able to use quite a bit of the information inside of these books. So here is another example. So I turned this time to the introduction to geometry, and we have been covering quite a bit of this lately in our just regular math studies. So I was like, this might be a good one for us. So I picked this one up, and this is a lot of the stuff we've been covering. So I'm going to have them go over these, the geometric shapes. And this is going to be perfect as I introduce this little kit to them. So we're going to go through these, and this will explain all of the tools that are inside of that little kit. So I was really happy and excited about that. I found another section of this book that I can use right now. This is what I have so far. So now I'm going to go and grab my binder with my plans from last week in it so I can go ahead and move forward with my plans for the next couple of weeks. This one might be a long one, but I hope it helps. I'm probably going to put some type of math or mathematician quote up there on those clouds. Here are some of my planning pages from these last few weeks. I think I showed you guys this already when I started planning out my Order in Our World unit. These two were my unit plans, and these were my last 4 weeks of plans. The week that I just completed, this was that week of plans. Now I'm going to be flipping over to the back and completing these plans. What I think I'm going to do for the boys' chalk wall is put math vocabulary there.
Friends, the kids were doing all sorts of things and their dad tried to send them inside because they were getting into mud and climbing up the trees and things. It was a lot. So they came stomping back in and I'm like, wait a minute, I'm planning. Like, you guys need to go back outside. So they're back outside now, which means that I'm free to just head into their room and try to get something on their boards.
We haven't actually cleared this one off in quite some time. It's been a minute. So I definitely want to make sure that I am using this space because it is like prime real estate in our homeschool. So I'm going to just clean off this whole thing here. And I think I'm going to look up on Pinterest some math vocabulary for the second grade / fourth grade and get as much math vocabulary as I can up on this wall.
That way this will give me like really good reference as we move through. So when they have a question about what is a vertex or what is an angle or whatever, perpendicular, whatever, we can come and head to this board and I can still keep my unit stuff up on the board in the homeschool room. So I'm thinking that's probably going to be a win. So that is what I'm going to do next, get this off of here and get some math vocab up on that wall. This is what I'm looking at. So this type of deal, this math word wall that you would use in a classroom. I just think it would be really beneficial to go ahead and put some of these things up on my wall. I don't need everything on the wall because a lot of these things they have a very good understanding of, but some of them I think will just be really helpful, like some of the conversion, some of the angle examples and things like that, partition, unit fraction. I just think it'll be really helpful to have these up on their wall. I mean, could this be considered my workout for the day? All right, it's all cleaned off and ready to go. Now I'm just gonna get some math vocabulary on this wall. And I don't know how long I'm gonna last, you guys. This might be a 2-day video or split up into two parts. So I'm kind of sort of done with my planning video for now so that I can get some dinner done. I'm gonna watch a YouTube video or two and catch up with some people I love so I can unwind a little. And Brian is gonna take the kids for a bike ride.